Hi folks, this is David Kwan here. So continuing to talk about Final Fantasy XIII-2. I talked a lot about the story of Final Fantasy XIII-2, and there's still actually more to say about the story of Final Fantasy XIII-2. But before I get to that, I do want to at least talk a lot more about gameplay. And gameplay-wise, I think Final Fantasy XIII-2 is a really easy game. It's not too difficult, like combat-wise, you know, in battle sequences. Like, compared to Final Fantasy XIII, the prequel, and what I'm playing right now, Lightning Returns Final Fantasy XIII, so sequel to Final Fantasy XIII-2, Final Fantasy XIII-2 is definitely the easiest, you know, battles kind of happen. You don't really have to strategize too much as long as you do a lot of battles. Doing a lot of battles will get you a lot of experience points, which you can use to upgrade the stats of the characters and make them more powerful. So, not too much strategy involved in the fights themselves. The fights are super flashy and they're really cool looking. You know, Final Fantasy XIII fights are the same that way. It doesn't really feel unfair. There are some tough fights that happen, and those are really interesting, like the optional boss fights that happen on the Wildlands and whatnot. But the story boss fights are not that hard. There's to get the alternate endings of Final Fantasy XIII-2, fighting against Caius, the main villain of this game. Man, for the alternate ending for the two of them. I think that was probably the most challenging boss fight in this game overall. But it's fairly easy to play. Combat-wise, it's not that engaging, people might say, and I would probably agree that this game is too easy. And the balance is kind of missing. Sometimes it's just way too easy, and you don't really require too much thinking other than, you know, to just do this move or that move. But it's flashy, and I like the customization of all the robot characters or the monsters that you could do. There's many types of monsters. And, you know, you get to explore all these areas and do side quests, so that's really cool. But the overall game itself, I think, is kind of hard, but not in a good way hard. Like, this game, you need a guide to get 100% in this game. I had to rely on GameFAQs.com a lot for this game, just to find out, oh, where do I go for to find out this side quest or to complete this side quest. I need this item. I need to go to this location on this time. So there's a lot of time travel and locations involved, and there's a lot of things to collect and a lot of hidden items to collect. And one side quest requires that you fill out the map 100%. So you explore every single crevice of every single map in the game. That is a side quest. So tedious and laborious, and on one map it's not possible unless you can get the chocobo, and you don't get a chocobo until you complete these three other side quests in which you beat optional bosses, and then you can get the chocobo to jump up to that one little area to finish 100% exploration of a map, of a level. That side quest was insane. The other side quest, and this is probably if you want to get a platinum trophy of this game, this one side quest is probably going to be the last side quest you complete. And that is to fight with every single monster in the game. Like, just once, at least once. But that one was ridiculous, because it's like I wasn't keeping track. I didn't know this was going to be a side quest. I wasn't really keeping track until I realized, oh, I have to do this. So I went to the wiki Final Fantasy page, and I checked off, like, okay, these are the ones I fought, and the game doesn't really give you an idea. Like, the game doesn't categorize, oh, these are the enemies you fought, these are the enemies, like, it doesn't do that. So I had to, like, do cross-referencing of the list of all the enemies in the wiki page, and making sure not to count the DLC enemies, so some enemies and bosses you can actually pay money to download to fight them in the Colosseum arena of the game, which I think is also ridiculous. DLC of this game, poorly done. I think all Final Fantasy XIII games, the DLC model was just crap. I think the sequel, Final Fantasy Lightning Returns, Final Fantasy XIII is the worst offender. But then again, I'm not going to spend any money on the DLC for that game, which is fine. Final Fantasy XIII-2 at least had cool playable characters you can download for money, which I didn't do. But you can download returning characters like Lightning and Saz and characters and Snow for money to be your third-party character. And they're really powerful, so that's cool. And Final Fantasy XIII-2 also has downloadable content of the prologue of Final Fantasy XIII-2, in which Lightning fights against Caius. And I think that's pretty cool. It's actually not that expensive. It's like, I don't remember how much it was, but I think it's about $5 or maybe a little over. But I thought that was interesting. But yeah, DLC for this game, poorly done. But anyway, that side quest where you have to fight against every single enemy in Final Fantasy XIII-2, that one's ridiculous because there's no good way to track it. And to track it, like, required me to do, go to the wiki pages and check off everything and make sure I did it right. And it's just like, go back to the quest giver periodically to say, did I get everyone? Did I get everyone? No, still didn't get everyone. And there's Academia 500 AF. Like, it's so random. There's just one enemy. There's a chance, there's a 50-50% chance of either this enemy appearing or this enemy appearing. You have that fight. If one enemy appeared, you have to reset the clock of that map and do it from do that level from the very beginning part to get there and hope and pray that there is, you know, you get the other enemy now. I mean, you get the gist, but that quest was just ridiculous. So some side quests, like, you're going to require a guide to do, but it is fun. Most of the other side quests, I think it's just kind of really fun just trying to explore all these other areas. It's a more open-ended experience, Final Fantasy XIII-2. And I think for that reason, this game kind of suffers in comparison to the prequel in some ways. But in a lot of other ways, that's what makes this game so enjoyable, I think. It kind of moves at its own pace. It moves at the pace that you want it to move it to. And there's just so many things to explore. It's kind of overwhelming when it opens up in the beginning this way. And you can go from here to there, and this time period, and that period. And there's a lot of multiple kind of plot details to find out about and to engage in. There's a lot of subplots that happen. And so I think all that is really intriguing. But to get the 100% quest completion, it is an extremely, extremely tedious affair. I do realize that, you know, for any RPG, getting 100%, or any open world game, like trying to get 100% on a Grand Theft Auto game, for example, so tedious. I don't think I've ever done 100% of a Grand Theft Auto game. Or any open world game, you know? Even Infamous, which I have a pretty good completion rate of, never got to 100%. Never got to 100% of Assassin's Creed or open world games like that. So I feel extremely proud that I got Platinum Trophy of Final Fantasy XIII-2. And there are a lot of great moments that I enjoyed throughout. You know, it's not a challenging game, it's a pretty easy game, but there's a lot of kind of things that they did with the gameplay that I really enjoyed. I enjoyed the streamlining of the Chrysanthemum level progression system. It's just, there's no thought involved now. There's really not much strategy to think, but the Chrysanthemum system of the prequel was, you know, of the original Final Fantasy XIII, I think it was a convoluted mess, and there's a lot of loading time involved, but this one is just like, oh yeah, do you have some points to use? Alright, do you want to be used for command, magic, or which role do you want to apply it to? And you just apply it to that role, and the character learns the roles and whatnot. Which monster do you want to use? And each role has a type, and you get to kind of choose. I think the combat is very much more streamlined, the gameplay feels more fluid, and I don't know, I really enjoyed this game, even though it was so easy, and even though after beating it and doing the post-game stuff was extremely tedious, but getting to learn kind of the extra details about it, and the extra ending you unlock by getting 100% complete, I liked it. It was fantastic. Kind of Kai is giving a monologue. That's all I'm gonna say, because otherwise it's a spoiler. Yeah, so you know, overall I really enjoy it, but in the next video I guess I will speak about the moments in the game that was like super, super frustrating and annoying. Every game kind of has that, and Final Fantasy XIII-2 sure had a couple of those moments, which I'm going to talk about in the next video.